Alright, what's up guys? Today I'm going to show you the Stonewall defense, but we're going to go through everything. This is going to be the advanced video. I'm going to go through all the different details. I'm going to give you the plans on what to do after you reach certain positions, and in this video I'm going to try to cover everything. I've been teaching Stonewall for a couple years now. My students love it. They get good positions, and I think going from 0 to 1800, Stonewall is probably one of the most perfect openings, and even one of my students went ahead and won the under 1800 World Open section, and that was really cool. And you play this Stonewall every single game. So d4, we're gonna start just classically. d5 to knight f6, f4. Now let's say e6. So first off, let's say if they go bishop d6, bishop d3, castle. Okay, so now if they go c5, we go c3. That's pretty standard. We have knight c6, knight e5 here is better. The problem with knight d2 is they can take on d4, and now we cannot play e takes d4 because the f4 pawn goes. So we would have to play c takes, but then knight b4 comes in, and now this position is kind of a pain. Another thing that I see a lot is knight g4, and I've had so many students forget about this e3 pawn, lose it, and then get forked and go on to be down an exchange and a pawn and just kind of lose the game. So make sure if they go knight g4, you are not losing this pawn on e3. So c3, knight c6, the best move is knight e5. So you guys know if c takes d4, we're going to play e takes, sorry. If c takes d4, we're going to play e takes d4, and if bishop takes e5, f takes d5. It's always a good day when they play knight takes e5 and just go ahead and lose a piece right off the bat. So let's say, for example, we'll just go over the rook lift real quick. So bishop d7, rook f3, rook h3, and then we have bishop takes h7, as we know, is winning and lights out. Now if they go like g6, for example, and kind of block it, at least momentarily, now the idea is you want to slowly bring all your pieces over to the king side. Kind of like a good Barcelona soccer. You want to just slowly move forward, wait for an opening, and then go to smash. So knight d2, we're going to go knight f3, maybe knight g5. If you have time, bishop d2, bishop e1, bishop h4. Then maybe like queen f3. g4, g5 is always a great way to get an attack. Basically, just move everything over to this side, and eventually you will break through. Because it's going to take them a while to kind of do anything over here. Okay, so that's what we're going to do if bishop d6, bishop d3, castle. Remember, if knight c6, we do the same thing, c3. So let's say c5. Remember, don't go bishop d2 because c4, so c3. So now if they go late c4, so late c4, we go bishop c2. And now you have two options. You can go knight d2 and push e4, which is always good. Whenever they go c4, e4 is going to be a lot stronger because they don't have any pressure on the d-pawn. Or you can just keep going with the rook lift, knight e5, rook f3, and life is good. So next, let's cover if they go, so we'll stick with d5, e3, let's say knight f6, f4, and this time if bishop f5. If bishop f5, we do the same exact thing, bishop d3. Generally, they're going to take, so let's cover take first. So take, queen takes, and eventually what I like to do here is try to push e4, so we're going to castle. Knight e5, you can still kind of rook lift here. It's not as strong, but it's still worse. You're going to have to mix in g4, g5, and once again, just bring all the pieces over to the king side, and eventually you will break through. So now bishop d3, let's say knight e4, so castle. So one mistake that I see a lot in this position is knight d2. So remember, you're in a line of fire here. So here they can go knight takes c3, attacking the queen, you have to take, and now they get your bishop. So now they've won the bishop pair, and they're up a pawn. So this would not be the best position. So what you got to do here is go queen e2 or queen c2, and then you can go knight d2 and try to move this knight from this outpost. So that is if bishop f5. Let's go over bishop g4 now. So bishop g4, we're going to go h3. The reason h3 is good is if bishop h5, we're just winning a piece. Remember, even if they sack here, which sometimes you will see, take, just go bishop e2, break the pin, and now you're going to try to castle queenside. And now let's say if take on f3, queen takes. Now we're going to go bishop d3, castle, and g4, g5 is going to be a very fun way to attack in these positions. So that's going to, for the most part, be all the d4, d5 lines. Okay, let's see if they castle queenside, because this is possible. So let's say, for example, like knight c6, castle, bishop d7, c3, oh, sorry, we should have played c3 before. Let's say queen e7, and then here we're still going to go knight d2. Remember, they have no take on d4 or anything. And let's say queenside castle. So if they castle queenside here, the way to attack is you're going to go b4, a4, a5. Remember, pawn storm. Whenever you castle opposite sides, it's very important to use your pawns to open up their king. Now he's going to try to do the same thing. Let's say h6, a4, and now g5. So a huge mistake here would be to take this pawn. When you take here, even though you're winning a pawn, which you're not even winning a pawn, you're opening up your king to the h and g files. With these h and g files, his attack is going to be so much faster than yours. So what you have to do here is go knight e5 and just try to lock it up. So when you're pawn storming and they're pawn storming, lock up their attack and focus on yours. So let's say, for example, he goes g4. Let's say he doesn't know what he's doing and he starts like pushing and locking it up. Now here, another mistake is do not go b5. If you go b5, they go knight a5, and now it's not the easiest to move this knight out of the way. So what's always better is to go a5. So let's say a5, h5, now we go b5, and now the knight cannot take here because the rook is supporting. The knight goes backwards. Once again, a6 I don't like because he locks it up. So we're going to, well, if he takes it, it'd be great. So we go b6, opening it up, and now your attack is going to be phenomenal. Even if you're sacrificing the pawn, you open up his king, you're going to get a good attack, and you will love these positions, I promise. So that, for the most part, should be all the d5 lines, except for maybe Stonewall. So let's go over knight f6 next. So if they're going to fianchetto, so let's say g6, and they play King's Indian, we go bishop d3 first, bishop g7, e4, castle, knight e2. The knight's always better on e2, that way you can push the f-pawn. Now, if they go d5, you just push e5 like this, c3, castle, and then everything is good. Let's say, for example, like this, f4. Maybe you can kind of rook lift here. Remember, it's not the best to rook lift against the fianchetto. What you really want to do is use your pawns to open them up. And let's say he tries to win this pawn over here. The way to defend here is just go bishop c2. Bishop c2, and you defend the pawn on d4. So that is what you do against d5. Now, if they go d6, castle, knight c6, here we go c3, e5. This is kind of always the break that you're going to see in the King's Indian. I'm going to go e5. You lock it up with d5, c4. Now you want to go knight c3, and if they go, let's say knight e8 first, now we can go f4. Actually, what I kind of like recently is just going knight c3, and if they go f5, just take. Open it up. Generally, they're going to play pawn takes, and then sneak in bishop g5. I think this is going to be portrayed a little bit better with knight h5, which you'll see a lot too. So knight c3, take, and now bishop g5. Let him push and make these pawns weak. This pin is annoying. And then you're going to try to chip away at these pawns and get to this exposed king. So that's what you're going to do against the King's Indian. Now let's go back. So that was g6. If e6 nimzo, f4, or maybe Queen's Indian like this. The idea is if they don't play d5, we're always going to try to push e4. Like if we go knight e5 here, he's just going to kick us with d6 and we're going to have to come back home. So we go knight d2. If he goes d6, e4. Now another mistake that I see in this position as white is people push these pawns too fast. Remember, you have a lot of space, but if you try to push these too fast, these pawns can start getting weak. You give him squares for his knight to go, there's holes in your position. So what you got to do here is just enjoy the view. C3, queen e2, develop all your pieces. Take your time, because he's cramped. If he doesn't have any moves. This kind of strategy is very dependent on white doing something and making weaknesses. You'll see this in martial arts and a lot of different things. Like counterpunchers, they want you to try too hard, and then they find the weakness or the hole, and they exploit it. So in these kind of positions, when you have this super center, just take your time, relax, and enjoy the advantage in space. So that's what we're going to do against e6. Remember, e6 can also transpose to other lines. Now, if d6, this is the same thing as King's Indian. Do not be tricked. Just go bishop d3. And since they have pawns here, they're going to go g6 and try to push this. And then you're going to go e4, knight e2, all the same kind of stuff. If they go c5 here, remember, as I said in the beginner video, do not break the wall. You have seen Game of Thrones, and you know how bad breaking walls lead to the position. So do not take here, just go f4. F4 and just keep rolling. If they take, and life is good. Now, what do you do if you get a Dutch? So f5, e3, we do the same exact thing. Now, the way to beat the Dutch is by pushing e4. So knight d2, and we're going to try to push e4 here. So bishop e7 is going to stop that. Now we're going to go queen e2, and let's say, for example, if they go d6, we go e4, and if you check your computers, you're already plus 1 here. The light squares for black are going to be so weak. Let's say take, knight takes, and then there's a lot of weaknesses. This pawn, this diagonal, white has very, very excellent prospects here. Now, if they stonewall back, so let's say this, and now d5. A little bit annoying, but we go bishop d3, bishop d6. Now, if someone is just straight up copying you and not thinking at all, go knight e5 here. because if they go knight e4, and this is a very important idea in a lot of Stonewalls, if they move the f-pawn, and same with you, when you move the f-pawn, always watch out for this check. So if f5, we're going to go queen h5 check. So queen h5 check, and even at my level, I've won a lot of blitz games with this idea. g6, and now we go knight takes. Now remember, if he takes here, we just take his rook, we're up an exchange and a pawn, we can trade queens, very, very easy to win. Black does have one saving grace with knight f6. So knight f6, now you can't take the rook because he's going to take your queen, so you got to move your queen away. You can go queen h4 or queen h3, and now his rook gets time to escape. So you go knight e5, you're up a pawn, he can't castle kingside, but it's not exactly game over. Like, you still have to be kind of careful here, but white is definitely doing well in this position. So now instead of knight e4, if he castles, so let's say knight e5, castle. So we're going to castle here, castle, castle, let's say they go knight e4. Now the key here is you have to rooklift first. Whoever rooklifts first gets to keep their rook on the attack and gets the attack. Because if black goes rook here, which sometimes they will, just take, and now they have an open and exposed king, and white is very happy with this position. So for the most part, that should be all that you see, except for one last gambit line with e5. So e5, on the other hand, instead of c5, we do take. This is a free pawn, and we want to punish him. It's a center pawn, white can get very good prospects if you do the right moves after this. So knight c6, knight f3. Let's say queen e7. Now here, a big mistake is bishop f4. Bishop f4 runs into all these kind of traps and tricks with queen b4 check. So here you go knight c3. Never try to hold on too much to a pawn and compromise the rest of your position just to be up a pawn. So knight takes e5. We're going to go bishop f4. Now let's say, for example, they go knight g6. Knight d5 is lights out. Hitting the queen, knight takes c7 check, and white is winning. So let's say they go knight takes f3 check, g takes. Now the plan for white is to go queen d2, castle queenside, push e4, and you have beautiful prospects here in this position. White is just dominating here. You will have a very fun time playing against this gambit. So for the most part, that's it. d5, you know what to do with bishop f5, bishop g4, rook lift, c5, knight c6, you go c3, all that kind of stuff. If f5, remember the Dutch, you're going to try to push e4. If you get e4 in, you're winning. The light squares are weak, you break through, and it's game over. If e5 this gambit, you just take, and remember, castle queenside, and you're cruising in that position too. And lastly, if knight f6, e3, if they go nimzo, remember, try to push e4, don't go knight e5 too fast, and then don't push the pawn. Once you get e4 in, don't push the pawns too fast, like I was saying before. So here, just go c3 and chill. Just take your time, enjoy the space, there's no rush. And instead of e6 nimzo, if they go, remember, c5, don't break the wall. If they go d6 and g6 are the same thing, don't get fooled. Go bishop d3 first, e4, knight e2. If d5, you lock it up. If d6, castle, and then c3, d5, c4. In knight e8 or knight h5, you're just going to go knight c3, f5, and take, and then go bishop g5, and just play against this open king. It's a very double-edged game, but I think both sides have good prospects here. And that's pretty much it. It is a lot to learn, and remember, these ideas, it's more, learn the ideas, because, I mean, you will get these positions probably, if you play the Stonewall, like 80% of the time. 20% is going to be some combination of these positions and the ideas that we went over. So just try to know all the ideas. Remember, play it a lot, check if you're doing the right thing, and if you want to test out, go to wolfchess.org, you can look at the homework, or you can take the opening quizzes to see if you really remember everything. So hope you guys enjoy this video. If you guys have any questions, let me know, and most importantly, hope you guys were entertained.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained?